Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Eclipse IDE on Windows operating system. And after that, I'll show you how to create a Java project on our Eclipse IDE and how to run that. So everything I am going to show you on this video itself. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel and press that bell button to get notified. And watch the video till the end. If you face any issues, you can always comment me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install Eclipse IDE, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here, Eclipse IDE download. Hit enter. So that will show you this eclipse.org. So just simply click on this Eclipse download. It's going to redirect to the Eclipse Foundation page. Here it is scroll down and you will get a download button. So click on this download button. So click on download x86. That's going to redirect to this page. Click on download over here. And there you go. Thank you for your download. And you can see that our Eclipse IDE is rightly started downloading. So you can see that our Eclipse IDE is rightly downloaded. Just click on this installer to install our Eclipse IDE. So our Eclipse installer is rightly open. Let's minimize our browser. And this is our Eclipse installation wizard. So here you can see that you can use Eclipse IDE for Java, then C++ or PHP, or you know, all these different languages. So on my previous videos, I have showed you how to use Eclipse IDE for C and C++, then PHP. So, you know, you can also watch my other videos if you want to use Eclipse IDE for all these languages as well. In this particular video, I'm going to show you about how to use it for Java. So I'm just going to click on this Eclipse IDE for Java developers. And there you go. So here, this is our Java path. So if you click on that, it is telling that you need to download Java JDK 23. So that's why it is showing this link as well. So select the latest one, which is 23, and also this is going to be our Eclipse installation folder. So everything is fine. Just simply hit install and it's going to ask you about this license agreement. You can always read this, accept now, and immediately you will see it is rightly started installing our Eclipse. So what it's going to do is, along with installing our Eclipse IDE, it's going to also install latest version of Java. So you just need to sit back. You need to also have your internet connection, obviously. So you need to just sit back, enjoy, and it's going to do all the things for you. And by the way, by the time it get installed, I request you to subscribe your channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos, and I have also posted a lot of videos on WordPress. So you can see all these different videos, 1 hour video, then 1 hour 30 minute video. So all these different videos you'll also get on our channel. So I'll recommend if you want to learn about how to create a e-commerce website for completely free, or a WordPress website with latest Astra theme and Elementor, like a gym website. So if you want to know all these things, then I recommend you to watch my other videos as well. So here, let's wait for some time. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our Eclipse IDE for Java developers is actually installed. Also desktop shortcut is rightly created over here. So let's click on this launch button to launch our Eclipse IDE, and can see that it is rightly started launching, and it is asking to select a workspace. So I'm going to keep it default. I'm going to use this default Eclipse workspace directory. So I'm going to select this, use this as a default workspace, and do not ask again, and click on launch. So that's going to start launch our Eclipse IDE, and it has rightly launched. So let's maximize it. So this is the interface of our Eclipse IDE. You can always read all these different tutorials. Yeah, just it's going to also redirect to your browser with their sponsor page. You can always donate some amount to them. They have really developed a very good product. Here, just simply click on cancel and also close this welcome note. And now let's create a simple hello world Java project. So you can always click on this create a Java project from here. So that's going to open this new Java project window over here, or else you can also go to file and you hover over new and you can click on this Java project from here as well. So that's going to open that same new Java project over here. Here you need to provide your project name. So let's give the project name as Hello World, and it's going to use latest version of Java, which is Java 23. If you want to use some older version, that also can do. You need to select it from this drop down. I'm going to use the latest one, which is 23, and all other things you need to keep it default. Only thing is module also, it has checked this create a module info.java file. We don't want to create any module info because it will be just a simple Hello World Java project. So we don't want to create any module. So just simply click on finish over here. So that's going to immediately start creating our Hello World project. You can see it is right to create it. So if you expand this, you'll get this JRE system library of 23. So if you expand, you'll get all these different libraries, right? So let's create a class file. So on our src folder, just right click and hover over new and click on class. So let's create a Java class. So it's going to be within Hello World src folder, and you need to provide a name over here. So let's give the name same as our project, so which is Hello World itself, and it's going to be a public static void main method. So let's select that. All right, so all other things you can keep it default and just simply click on finish. So that's going to immediately start creating our Hello World file. You can see it is actually created, and that same file is also opened over here, right? So let's write something, a simple code, and let's print that. So just give a tab over here and let's assign a couple of values, let's say equal to 5, and let's say int b equal to 2. Hit enter, and let's do a summation of these two numbers. So system dot out dot println, and within that let's print summation of these two numbers. So sum equal to,
and give plus a plus b, so within bracket let's write a plus b and end with a semicolon. So we want summation of these two numbers, a plus b, which should be 7, 5 plus 2. So that is what we want to show on our output. So just go to file and let's save this file and click on this run button. And you can see the output is properly coming on our console, right? Sum equal to 7. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of Eclipse IDE and you can start working on your Java projects within Eclipse IDE. Do mention on our conversations if you have faced any issues in middle. I am always there to help you. And also don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. That's going to really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. And also if you're interested, you can also watch my WordPress videos as well. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.